We are going to add a checkbox to our controls panel. To avoid redundant work, set the style right now in the resources. Also, let's limit the width of the combo box to 135. Add a new checkbox after the combo box. Give it a name. I will make it initially checked. In the click event, if the checkbox is clicked, we will pick a random color from the combo box. Create a new condition which checks the IsChecked property of the checkbox. If it is true, set the selected index to a random number. The max value in the next method should be equal to the count of items in comboColor. Increase the width of your window, because we will need more space for controls. Next, we are going to let the user change the background color. The logic behind it is almost identical to a combo box for brush colors. I will limit its max width to 100. Avoid redundant work and just copy-paste the data template from the previous combo box. In your constructor, copy the lines where you set the item source and selected index for combo box with brush colors. If you hold the Alt key, you will be able to edit multiple rows in the same column position. Instead of setting the background in C#, I suggest that we bind the background of the grid to the selected item of the combo box, specifically to its rectfill property. If you want the background to be white, you can select the white color by going from the end. Subtract the position of the color starting from the end from the count of all items in the combo box. We will need more space later, so I will reduce its max width. If you think it is dumb, you are right. When you have only two or three buttons, you can do without any special container. But normally you still need to use something more specialized. There are several containers to choose from, but toolbar will do. But note that all your controls inside a toolbar have a slightly different style. I recommend adding separators here to make the logical parts in your interface. If you want to remove those dots on the left side of the toolbar, set its isLocked property to true. Talking about the checkbox, its style is completely different and not quite intuitive. We can restore it by placing the checkbox in the grid or changing its style.